Hi guys, welcome back to Ajit channel. Today we will be discussing the pathology of triangles or the so-called equine distemper. Triangles is among the oldest and most important disease of equines, which is mainly affecting the neck lymph nodes, and the breathing sounds will be different, and the guttural pouch and the iliopharyngeal lymph nodes will be affected. Triangles can affect horses, donkeys, mules of all ages, but usually younger than of 2 age, that is below the 2 age, they will be affected more. So, etiological agent is the Streptococcus equi, Streptococcus bacteria equi species and subspecies equi. Less commonly, the bacteria may affect lymph nodes in the thorax and abdomen, causing syndrome known as metastatic or bastard triangles. Susceptible horses are mainly also ponies and camels, and also donkeys can get affected. Transmission is through direct horse-to-horse contact, that is the material, that is the nasal discharges, the saliva, etc. can spread infection sometimes. Indirect, that is contaminated fomites, that is contagious disease. You can get it from the buckets, grooming tools, blankets, handles, tracks, etc. veterinary equipments. So incubation period will be 2 to 3 days. Basically, nasal shedding begins usually 2 to 3 days after onset of pyrexia. Pyrexia will begin on after the 2 to 3 days of bacterial invasion. So the pathogenesis following entry into a new host, Streptococcus equi attaches primarily to the cells on the tonsillar crypts and the tonsillar lymph nodes and the ventral surface of soft palate. Then they will be reproducing in the lymph nodes at an alarming rate. They will be producing many bacterial copies, and this will be getting into the blood and systemic circulation. This leads to what? Systemic invasion. The organism slowly multiplies in the lymph node. Subsequent migration of neutrophils into the lymph nodes causes swelling and abscess. Clinical signs usually present fever will be there, pharyngitis, and soft non-productive cough is there usually when eating. Mucopurulent and nasal discharge can be unilateral or bilateral, but mostly mucopurulent thick yellowish creamy discharge will be coming from the both nerves. Lymphadenopathy plus abscess will be there. Upper airways will be stitched and they will be having secondary compression. Guttural pouch empyema is the main problem and the frequency equal to previous lymph node abscess. So you can see the lymph node abscess. This is very large in a fold, very large abscess in a fold in the pharyngeal lymph nodes. So you can see small abscess and the lacrimal discharge, that is thick creamy yellowish nasal discharge. Also see, this is an abscess. Creamy yellowish nasal discharge that can be sometimes unilateral or bilateral. Edema and the lacrimal discharge. This is abscess formation inside the eye. You can see the abscess has burst and the fluid is coming out. This is the pus. The pharyngeal lymph node that has got abscess and this has broken. See, the entire contour of the animal get decreased. You can see those images. Creamy yellowish. See, small enlargement. This is the in the first stage of empyema. So you can see the posterior of the guttural pouch is actually here. Retropharyngeal lymph nodes are present here. So from the guttural pouch and if the mandibular lymph node, the infection will be spreading to the other lymph nodes. And this leads to the breakage and the abscess and the tumor formation. So macroscopic strangles is rarely fatal. That is, if a horse dies in acute phase of disease necropsy, you will be very, very hard to find the lesions. Internal abscess can form in the lung, liver, spleen, kidney, brain, mediastinum, or mesentery, etc. Myocarditis will be there. Purpura hemorrhagica leads to petechial and achemicotic hemorrhages. And rhabdomyolysis and progressive atrophy will be seen in the quarter horses. So these are the Streptococcus bacteria. When we are viewing under the microscope, that is the scab lesions. So diagnosis is usually pharyngeal sap testing. So aspirates of the abscess. Abscess will be testing. Serum will be testing. Nasopharyngeal washes will be testing. Test can be considered PCR, PCR, serological titer, etc. So control and prevention is quarantine of new horses into the farms or the new stacks. Avoid share water buckets. Avoid sharing the things which can lead to the contamination of good horses from the infected horses. So treatment is actually through the, you have to treat the cause and the source. That is, you have to treat for streptococcus infection. That is, you have to treat with penicillin mostly. And you have to also give betadine ointment. And we have to prevent the secondary bacterial infection, which will be coming in the later stage. So this is the treatment method and isolation of the scabs. So one of the more difficult to identify complication is called the bastard spangles, which occurs when the infection spreads internally, that is in the intestinal flora. The streptococcus bacteria will be producing more lesions that can lead to even colic. So glanders and strangles should be always compared and studied. So if you want to see the video of glanders, I'll be giving the link in the description box. And if you want to learn more about the Streptococcus bacteria, I'll be giving the link also in the description box. Thank you.